Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I want to talk to you about recording expenses in QuickBooks Online. Let's just go with a manual expense and not something downloaded from bank feeds. I'm going to click on plus new in the upper left-hand corner. I'm going to go to vendors and then expense. The question that came up was that a student wanted to know, what's the difference between a category and the item details? How do you know which one you should use when recording your expenses? Well, the short answer is you can use either. The short answer is the category is the account on your chart of accounts. So it can be anything. It can be a different bank account. It can be an expense account. It could be an asset account, whatever it is. It doesn't matter that the upper left-hand corner says expense. So your category says, go directly to my chart of accounts and choose something there. Your item detail says, go to the middleman, and then the middleman will go to the chart of accounts. So when I choose my item details and I look at my different products and services, you can see there's some income like beverage income, but then there's some stuff like some buttons and some inventory, some fountains and some rocks. Let me just take you over to the products and services list. I'll spend just a moment showing you what that looks like. So I'm going to close out of here. In the upper right-hand corner, I'm going to click on the gear. Under the header for a list, I'm going to go to products and services. This is my products and services list. Every time I select something in the name column, that's going to be the bottom half of my expense. That's going to link or automatically assign that dollar value to the account listed in the expense column. And so really, this name column is the middleman, so the information can go over to the expense column. If you're not sure or not comfortable with products and services, I have a different video that goes over that. I just wanted to give you a brief overview that says, hey, when you're logging an expense, you can choose an account and post it directly to your chart of accounts, or you can choose an item, which will then select a product and service, and the product and service will be the middleman that then posts the information to the related account. Thank you so much. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave them in the comments down below. If there are other videos you'd like to see me make or other concepts you'd like to see me explain, don't hesitate to reach out and let me know. Thanks.